all I'm saying is I think they should support full investigations of all of these things, which John McCain and Lindsey Graham are trying to do. These are Republicans trying to do this. I don't think that we shouldn't think that there's not a lot of political fraughtness around this, but that, you know, tech companies especially have been hard hit by hacking for years, and any support they can give to these investigations to find out exactly what's going on would be great. And I think they have a lot of expertise in the area. They should support, you know, and publicly support full and, you know, fulsome findings around this. And I'm not quite clear why President-elect Trump wants to not do that. I mean, I think that's the issue I have. And if he wants to not do that or not wants to only investigate one or the other, I think we should investigate the entire thing because it really impacts the tech community here. It impacts our economy. It impacts their ability to do business. And it's a concern to everybody in the United States.
What kind of disclosure, Kara, do you think would be heard, though? Because we've had the founders of CrowdStrike, which were hired by the DNC back in May when they first realized that there was some rogue actor in the system. Yeah. And they will say loud and clear on the record that it is Russia, that it has the markations of Russian code that is something unique to other situations that they've seen involving Russia. I mean, how much will it take to actually, from the tech community, to actually convince people who are skeptical?
Well, I think there are some statements that just general, it's the same thing I've been talking about. It's general statements of principle and in terms of how what can be done and to lend its, you know, its expertise to or support to someone like John McCain who's trying to get to the bottom of this. I think what's interesting about that quote from Trump today is nobody said we shouldn't investigate China, too. I'm not sure why. You know, that's just being thrown out there to cast doubt and aspersions. Nobody said we shouldn't be looking into all the hacking by China, which is extensive, and I think we know that. But this is a really important issue, and it's not a political witch hunt. It's what happened here. Let's figure out what happened, how to stop it, and what to do about it going forward, because it's only going to get worse as we move forward. And I can't imagine anybody, whether Republican or Democrat, wants to be manipulated by foreign governments in this manner. And I think there's nothing wrong with finding out. And that's, and I think the tech community can help do that and lend full support and weight, whether via lobbying, via public statements, via behind-the-scenes help, so that we can get to the bottom of this. And as difficult as it is, and what's the problem? Is saying it's confusing doesn't mean anything. What we should try to do is try to take that confusion and make it into some sort of clarity if we can.
Of course, we've seen companies who've been targeted by Trump even in the past 48 hours. Do you get the sense that Silicon Valley firms have the nerve to step into this debate knowing what could come back at them on Twitter?
Well, that's a self-interest thing. I think this is in the interest of our whole country. I think that's what they were talking about. There's nothing wrong with skepticism about intelligence information. Of course we should have skepticism. That's the whole point of the check and balance system. I think skepticism is different than just casting aspersions with no evidence and making it confusing and saying we shouldn't look into this. Obviously we should look into this, no matter how it comes out. And so I think that they have to make a decision, just the way Apple did on encryption, that this is a bigger issue than just their companies. Apple has gone on the line, went far out on a limb on that issue, and because they felt it was an important, critical issue. The same thing about foreign hacking. Tech companies, not just tech companies, every company should be worried about this issue, and every citizen in the United States should be worried about this issue. And again, the more we can figure out what happened, we can figure out what's going to happen and what we can do about it going forward. And I don't know why that's an unreasonable thing to want to do. And that President-elect Trump has made it unreasonable to look into things is I find it unusual. And,
Kara,
and I don't know. I'm glad John McCain is there. I'll tell you that.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.